Seamus Callanan's been named Hurler of the Year, and let's be honest, it would have been absolutely ridiculous if he wasn't. So it's the fourth time he's been nominated, 2014, 15, 16, the three times. I'd say if Tip had to win it in 14, he definitely would have got it, even scored the 6 points from play against Kilkenny the first day, the 2 goals from play the second day. But I think when Kilkenny came out on top, they were always going to get the Hurler of the Year that year. Same in 15. Had a brilliant run all the way to the All-Ireland that year. Scored 5-5 from play as it was. And I think Tipperary suffered badly in that All-Ireland semi-final, that too much of what they did was supposed to be into Callanan and Callanan alone. And he ended up with a hat-trick and more points from play. But overall, did every other forward on the Tipperary team suffer for that, and therefore the collective, because the other forwards just weren't being utilised as much. And I mean, that's the way Eamon O'Shea set it up, and that's the way it went. But 2016, like that split vote where Pádraig Maher and Seamus Callanan, they were nominated alongside Austin Gleeson, and the votes ended up being split. Gleeson got Hurler of the Year. I don't think that's the way it should have gone. At the time, I would have picked Pádraig Maher to be Hurler of the Year, but Seamus Callanan definitely was a lot of people's choice. And I think overall, his overall body of work, he definitely deserves a Hurler of the Year at this point. And that's often the way it kind of pans out. Certainly for Joe Canning in 2017, it definitely wasn't his performances that year alone, because he was probably fourth or fifth best player for Galway in that particular team. But over the course of his career, that you'd imagine that's the way it's going to be. For Callanan to score a goal in every single game en route to the championship, and that is 8 games, 8-18, 8-17 for play. And it's an outrageous return, 96% from play. And probably shouldn't have been. It was probably never in doubt. And especially once the nominations were announced and Noel McGrath wasn't in there, because Noel McGrath definitely should have been nominated. Like, some outrageous performances en route to the All-Ireland title. And I'd say every Tipperary player was poor in the Munster final, but other than that, but when Noel McGrath wasn't nominated, it's probably got to be a shoe-in for Callanan, because I'm sure other players appreciated him so much and thought he has to get it. TJ Reid had a brilliant year, no doubt about that. Patrick Horgan had some excellent games. Of course, the Kilkenny one stands out, 3-10, but Cork didn't make a Munster final. Cork didn't even get past the All-Ireland quarterfinal stage, so it would have been fairly ludicrous. If you look at Callanan's body of work over the years that he's been playing, from 2008 to 2019, and obviously he'll kick on again next year. Of his 53 championship games, he scored in 50 of them, and he's been held scoreless from play in just 7 of those games, which is just a phenomenal record. If you look at the scores he's got from play, in total he's scored 35-215, which is 320 points, 35-108 from play, 213, so 213 of 320. 57% of everything he's got is from play, and that's a guy who took frees for a number of years also, so that's an incredible return. And there's nobody in the championship who can compare it with what he's done. Also, look at the amount of goals, 35, like, who can compare with that? And especially with them being all from play, just to name some of the rivals there. Joe Canning has 27, 17 of those from play. Patrick Horgan is 21, 15 from play. TJ Reid, 22, 15 from play. So there's pretty much no one in the same bracket. So I think over the course of the years, Callanan has definitely delivered enough to get it as a body of work over his career. But on the merit of 2019 alone, it had to be Callanan. Let me know what you think, if you agree, disagree. Is there anyone else who should have even been nominated?